Thank you. gather this morning to honour those who 100 years ago came from the ends of the earth to join the fight for peace and freedom for all people. May our service this morning, our words and our deeds, be worthy of the efforts and sacrifices they made. May we gain a sense of the price they paid that enables us to stand here today in peace and freedom and carry the pride of New Zealand. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
At this precise moment, 100 years ago, a trench just a few paces north of where we are now standing was taken by the men of the 2nd Otago and 2nd Auckland Infantry Battalions. This position was then the German front line and known as Switch Trench. It was the first objective of an assault that had been launched only 40 minutes earlier. À ce moment précis, il y a 100 ans, une tranchée à quelque part à peine au nord d'où nous nous trouvons fut prise par les hommes des 2e bataillon d'infanterie de l'Otago et de Auckland. Cette position constituait alors la ligne de front allemande, connue sous le nom de Switch Trench. Ce fut le premier objectif d'un assaut qui n'avait été lancé que 40 minutes plus tôt. Casualties were heavy. For the Otagos, under withering fire from German machine guns located in high wood, the cost was catastrophic. They lost 460 men, nearly three quarters of their strength. That the attack nevertheless succeeded was due in no small measure to the exceptional courage of Sergeant Donald Forrester Brown. He, together with a comrade, twice advanced to within a few yards of German machine guns and put them out of action. For this, and for single-handedly capturing another machine gun in a later attack, Brown was posthumously awarded the Victoria Cross. Les pertes furent importantes. Pour ceux de l'Otago, sous le tir meurtrier des mitrailleuses allemandes à Highwood, le coup fut catastrophique. Ils perdirent 460 hommes, près des trois quarts de leur effectif. L'attaque fut néanmoins un succès, et ceci est dû, dans une large mesure, au courage exceptionnel du sergent Donald Forrester Brown. Avec un camarade, ils s'avancèrent par deux fois à quelques mètres des mitrailleuses allemandes et les neutralisa. Pour cela, et pour avoir capturé à lui seul une autre mitrailleuse dans une attaque ultérieure, Brown reçut à titre posthume la Croix de Victoria. The 15 September offensive was conducted by 10 British and Commonwealth divisions. It was intended to be the final decisive push of the Battle of the Somme. Instead, for the New Zealanders, the battle was but their first encounter with the full horror of industrialised war. Even the Gallipoli veterans amongst them were staggered by the utter devastation of the landscape into which they marched, and the scale and the smell of death. L'offensive du 15 septembre fut conduite par la 10 division britannique et du Commonwealth. Ce devait être l'ultime charge de la bataille de la Somme. Mais au lieu de cela, pour les Néo-Zélandais, la bataille ne fut que la première confrontation avec toute l'horreur de la guerre industrialisée. Parmi eux, même les vétérans de Gallipoli furent atterrés par la dévastation totale du paysage dans lequel ils marchaient, ainsi que par l'ampleur et l'odeur de la mort. The Somme is where the New Zealanders fought together in a battle as a complete division for the first time. It is also where we suffered our greatest losses. Over the 52 days that the New Zealanders were present, the division suffered close to 8,000 casualties over half its strength. Of those 8,000, more than 2,000 lost their lives. It took less than 8 weeks to accumulate losses equaling those suffered at Gallipoli over 8 months. C'est dans la Somme que les Néo-Zélandais ont pour la première fois combattu ensemble comme une division complète. C'est aussi là que nous avons subi nos pertes les plus lourdes. Au cours de 52 jours pendant lesquels les Néo-Zélandais furent présents, la division subit près de 8000 victimes, plus de la moitié de son effectif. De ces 8000, plus de 2000 perdirent leur vie. Il fallut moins de 8 semaines pour accumuler les pertes équivalentes à celles de Gallipoli qui dura 8 mois. For New Zealand, the Somme has become synonymous with courage in the face of great suffering and terrible loss. It is a legacy shared by all the nations who fought in this battle. Today, this shared history is one of the many strands that tie us to those with whom we were allied, as well as to our former foes. Over time, reconciliation has been built into friendship that stands alongside the other friendships forged during those terrible weeks in September and October 1916. Pour la Nouvelle-Zélande, la Somme est devenue synonyme de courage face à la grande souffrance et de pertes dramatiques. C'est un héritage partagé par tous les pays qui ont combattu dans cette bataille. Aujourd'hui, cette histoire partagée est l'un des nombreux maillons qui nous relie à ceux avec qui nous étions alliés et également à nos anciens adversaires. Au fil du temps, la réconciliation s'est consolidée en amitié qui s'érigèrent désormais aux côtes des autres amitiés forgées pendant ces terribles semaines de septembre et octobre 1916.
Many New Zealand families will tell you that when their men returned, they never talked about the Battle of the Somme. They could not find the words to speak the unspeakable. The psychological ordeal began as soon as the soldiers arrived. Their starting positions were choked with the bodies from the earlier fighting. Captain Lindsay Inglis remembered how the dead of both sides, swelling and sodden, heaved out of the crumbling ditches that passed for trenches. Our generals knew what to expect, and they built that knowledge into their planning. Each of the four set-piece attacks was fought with a single brigade, with the expectation that the brigade would be used up. A fresh brigade would then be brought up to conduct the next set-piece. It was by these means that the battle was continued for 23 grueling days. Respite for the men was brief and was always within enemy artillery range. At the end of the battle, the New Zealand Division had to be completely rebuilt. Our politicians, knowing the cost of fighting on the Western Front, had already filled up the training camps in England with replacements. Every set piece left hundreds of men lay dying and wounded. Body parts were scattered over the fields, for many death did not come instantly, but followed a lingering agony. Private William Innes wrote home to the family of his friend, Harry Beach, who was hideously mutilated by a shell on the first day. "It was a godsend when he died," he told Harry's father, "as he must have suffered awful, and I think you would have said the same if you had seen him." The overwhelming mental and physical fatigue experienced by the soldiers is difficult to overstate. 2 days into the attack, the weather broke. The soil turned into a quagmire and the trenches filled with freezing water. "For night after night," wrote Sergeant Cecil Malthus, "we hardly slept, we became unspeakably weary and sick of it all." By the end, remembered Private Howard Kippenberger, "we were almost crying, worn out and cowering like children from every shell." Acts of self-sacrifice and compassion shone through his dark hours like lanterns in the storm. Because of these, and because of the comradeship of the men, the terrible cost was borne. After the battle, the division was showered with praise. No other division had fought for so long or advanced so far. But it is not for these reasons that the names of Somme 1916 and Flair Corselet are emblazed on the regimental colour of the 3rd Auckland and Northern Battalion here beside us. These battle honours are carried so that we never forget the service and the sacrifice of those who fought here.
Thank you. February 1938, on the eve of another war, the New Zealand Returned Services Association Review published extracts from the diary of a gunner at the Somme. The writer, Archibald Kirk Greaves, who served with 14 Battery, New Zealand Field Artillery, was to be known only by his service number, 11-2108. The diary records his experiences over the 52 days the gunners were present on the battlefield. Well, a new battlefield has a smell very hard to explain. High explosives, cordite, fumes, and gases, mixed with rotten corpses and carcasses of mules and horses. A rotten egg being rammed down one's throat may come near it. If the civilian police could bottle the smell, it would be a great thing for breaking up riots. A wild screech, crash, a beauty, a high explosive burst within 5 yards of us. The mud was our saviour. We were plastered with it. When we arrived back at the battery, I had a piece of mud the size of my two fists sticking on my tin hat. My tongue and lips were dry, the other drivers being likewise. Had the ground been hard, we would have been blown to pieces. If shrapnel, we would have been finished up like a colander. A corporal from another battery had been killed during the night. The body is lying on the road. The ammunition wagons are running over him. This particular bit of road is under direct observation, and we do it at a gallop. In fact, the horses do it at a gallop without any persuasion. It would be suicide for us to stop to remove the body. Going in this morning, the ammunition was bouncing around a great deal. At a critical moment, the pole came up and caught my leg on it. The four lead horses pulling like blazes, I could feel myself being pulled well and truly out of the saddle. In a desperate effort to free myself, I savagely put my whip onto my horses. The sudden jump forward freed me. For a brief moment, I pictured myself being in the same condition as the corporal whom we ran over every day with the ammunition. The corporal, who I mentioned 4 days ago, is still where he fell. Going in this afternoon, the wheels of the ammunition limber ran right down his backbone. The head came adrift from the body and was pushed out of sight into the mud. Another New Zealander, who reported, believed killed in action. Sailagia.
Let us pray for peace. Lord, as we stand here today and reflect on the feats of our fellow countrymen from 100 years ago, we acknowledge that the price of peace was and still is high. We give thanks for those who have answered their country's call to serve throughout the ages and again in these troubled times we live today. We pray that those in positions of authority throughout the world would lead and govern wisely and be willing to continue to work in unity for peace where there is conflict, justice where there is persecution, freedom for the oppressed, and equality for all people. We pray for the peace of the world, your peace that passes all understanding, so that those who fought for peace here will know the price they paid was not in vain. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
The Honourable Jerry Brownlee, on behalf of the Government and People of New Zealand, au nom du gouvernement et du peuple néo-zélandais, Jean-Marc Todeschini, on behalf of the French Republic, Jean-Marc Todeschini, au nom de la République française. Lieutenant General Tim Keating, Chief of Defence Force, on behalf of the men and women of the New Zealand Defence Force, au nom des forces armées néo-zélandaises, Et le général Thierry Coqueblin, au nom des forces armées françaises, on behalf of the French armed forces. Bob Hill, on behalf of the Royal New Zealand Returned and Services Association, au nom des anciens combattants néo-zélandais.
Nei a tātou kua mahu ene. E kore o ki rātou e ngoi kore. Aha koa pēhea I ngā āhuatanga o te wā. I te heke ngātu o te rā, tai noa ki te aranga mai I te ata. Ka maumahara toni tātou ki a rātou. Ka maumahara toni tātou ki a rātou.
They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
May we, your servants, depart from here in peace. May your eternal peace be with those we leave here and with those whose resting place is known only to you. May we treasure the memories of this day always, so those who fought for peace here will never be forgotten. And may the Lord be with you to defend you, within you to keep you, before you to lead you, beside you to guard you, and above you to bless you. In Jesus' name, Amen.